Okay, so now what we're going to go through is the client-server program, which I also posted another video on this, but let me go over it one more time in this video and show you how to run this. You want to establish a connection from a client to a server. When you do socket program, make sure you import this java.net package as well as the java.io package. Okay, and you don't really need the util package, but not sure though. So let's go ahead and just import the util package though also. Okay, all right. What we need is when a client tries to contact a server, right? So it's like a client is like a sender. It's like trying to send something to a server. First a connection request, and then the sequence of big integers. That's what this program is going to do. The client is first going to establish a connection, so this is going to establish the connection, and then the client is going to send a sequence of big integers. Okay, so for either of this, the client needs to know what is the machine name in which a server is running, as well as what port number the server is running. Okay, so a process running on a machine is identified using the machine name as well as its port number, right? So the machine name is in turn translated to its IP address. So we get the machine name as an input argument and get the IP address equivalent of that. That's this inet address is the name of the class for the IP address, and this is the name of the object I'm just using. And then this is the port number that I'm going to pass as the input argument at which the server is running. So I'm getting these two arguments, and then I am opening up a client, a socket of name client socket, and trying to connect to the server by passing the server IP address and port number. So let's go to the server program. So the server program uses two socket classes. One is a server socket class and the other is a socket class itself. So the server socket, this is how you create it. You create it by making it to run on a specific port number. So the port number is the argument you're passing as a command line argument. So this is the port, same port number the client will be using to connect to the server. And then you call the accept method on the server socket. So by this, the server is waiting. So this is a blocking call. So the server is basically waiting for to receive an incoming client request. Okay. So once this request from the client reaches a server, that accept method will be unblocked. Okay, and the server program can continue. So now, if you see the client program, what we have done is we are opening an object output stream. So always in socket programming, you use an output stream to print something onto the socket. When I say I print something onto the socket, it means I'm sending something on the socket. Okay. So here we are going to send objects because we are going to send big integers, right? In your project one also, you're going to send big integers. So I'm going to create, this is a kind of a wrapper class-based constructor. So I'm calling this getOutputStream method on this client socket object of class socket, which I created, and wrap it up with this object output stream constructor. So you can follow the same syntax in your program also. So this is the object output stream class, and you're creating an object of it. Okay. And then I'm running a for loop. I'm going to send a sequence of 10 big integers. And what are those 10 big integers? In this example, I'm just generating them randomly. Okay, so in your project, those will be the encrypted ciphertext characters of your name. Okay, so I'm going to that's why I created this random number generator. So we saw earlier that we'll use this probable prime method of the big integer class, and we are going to create 32-bit big integers and pass this random number generator, and I'm getting a big integer. And this is the method that you use to send an object. So not send, yeah, you put the object. Write object means it puts the object onto the socket. Okay, on the object output stream of the socket. So you pass a big int object onto the write object method, and then you flush it. So this is essentially going to send this object from the client to the server. So you're going to send like this 10 objects. So now if you look at the server side, Now also, after you send all the 10 objects, you want to indicate to the server that you're done with sending whatever you wanted to send to make life easy. So you are going to send what is called a negative one as the last object to the server. Okay, so you wrap it up as a big integer and you do the same thing. You write it as an object or call the right object and put it on this and then you flush it. So this sends the last argument object to the server side. So now what the server is doing, so it has to keep receiving the objects until it sees that it has received a negative one. Okay, so I kind of create a big integer of value negative one over here and then run an infinite while loop, because from the server side it doesn't know how many big integers it's going to receive. Like in your project, names could be any number of characters, right? So the server, the receiver, doesn't know how many characters it is going to receive. So you put typically the receiver program, in this case server program, in an infinite while loop until you get a negative one, indicating the end of the transmission of the characters or the big integers in this case. So you put the infinite while loop and then you call the read object method on the object input stream. Okay, so you call the read object method on the object input stream. In Java, there is super class of type object. So whenever you send anything on the socket, it is received as of type object. So this is essentially typecasting that to a big integer. Okay, so then once you typecast it, you get a big integer, and then you use the equals method to check whether it is equal to negative one. If it is equal to negative one, it means that's the end of the transmission, right? So you break from this infinite while loop. Otherwise, you could keep going, and you have not received big negative one if you reach this line. So whatever the big integer was received, you could print it out. Okay, so this is the infinite while loop that receives all the characters that the client is sending. And then once you are done with this, you can come out, then you can close this socket that you use to communicate with the client. And this server program doesn't do anything else. Typically, you don't close your server socket, you run your server program servers all the time, right? But here we don't do anything else, so we can also close the server socket. See, remember you opened two sockets, right? The server socket, and then that spawned this socket, right? So we have to make sure that we close both the sockets, right? So let me run this. So for this, you need two command windows. So let me open another window. Right, so let me compile one in each of this window. So you would run the server first because the server has to wait for the incoming client request. So let me clear the window. So run the server. So this is the name of the class that I used here, where I have the main program. So you see here the server program accepts only one argument. So that is the port number at which you're running. So let's say I'm using 1234. So when you press enter, it's like a blocking call, because you see after you enter the port number and all these things, it is waiting for the accept method to be unblocked. So you have not yet started the client. So now let's go ahead and start the client. The client takes two arguments. The two arguments are the port number at which the name of the client server machine. So this is a class name. So now the name of the server machine, if you're running locally, just say localhost. If you're running it on Red Hat 3, you will say, or any servers, the name of the server. Okay, so if you run it on Red Hat 3, you could say what? Red Hat 3.jsums.edu. But in this project, you could just use the local host. Okay? And this is the same port number that you need to use here. Okay, and this is a port number at which the server is running and waiting for a client request. So that's the same port number to which you want to connect to the server. So press enter. And you see here this client has sent all the 10 big integers randomly generated and they are printed out here. So if you run the program again, you would get another sequence of 10 random big integers. Okay? So let me stop.